Hey guys, this is Pablo with D&D Gaming, and today we're going to be doing a review of the game Fury Unleashed, developed and published by Awesome Game Studios. This game is coming out 2020 for PC, Xbox One, PS4, and Nintendo Switch, but you can actually download the game right now on Early Access on the Steam platform. The game is set up in a comic book setting where you just go through the pages of a comic book, shooting up your enemies in a Metal Slug-inspired visuals. The base of the game is for you to find out why John Kowalski, the creator of that comic book series, is having a creativity crisis, and you gotta help him to find out how to solve that problem. The game offers players two game difficulties, hard and easy mode, action platforming with 360-degree shooting, combo system, randomized levels, items, and events, permadeath with character progression, lots of game-changing items, and a captivating soundtrack composed by Adam Skorupa and Kirstoff Wierzykiewicz, who have also created tracks for The Witcher, Bulletstorm, and Shadow Warriors 2. Now guys, this review is a big deal for me because I was actually given the keys for this game so I could review it. So it was a big deal. One of the major things for me is the style of the game. The idea is really great. Always remember, that's not a big studio, but one thing I learned for a long time is that sometimes a small studio put a lot more passion in the product they actually give to the players. And this game made me, really reminded me a lot of Metal Slug, my times playing arcade, and, you know, receiving my allowance on the first, and 2 hours later have to ask my dad for more allowance because, yeah, Metal Slug just took all my money. But hey, I will say, this game was actually interesting. I played for a few hours. First time I played on easy mode, you know what I mean? You gotta try the game, you don't wanna just get wiped out right away. And I died pretty quick. And I was like, wow, that's easy mode, that's great. So, as I mentioned, that's permadeath. So you go all the way from the beginning of the first comic book. Now, one thing I love is, they make the game easier. Not as per se by making it easier, but by giving you the option of upgrading your character. So while it's permadeath, you still keep the levels you gain through the game. So you upgrade your items, you upgrade your character, and the next time around you go to play the game, you're more powerful than that. So with this, they actually make the game easier for you, but it has to do with how quick you died, and how many times you died, and what point of the game you got. I'll be honest, until I played this game, I thought I had left platform shooters all the way back to NES and SNES, and I was wrong. I was actually almost scared to actually review that game, because while it seemed interesting, I really didn't think I was going to, you know, wrap my head around a platform shooter. I haven't played those games for a long time. Actually tried to play back Mega Man on the Xbox, and I just couldn't do it. There are some mechanics that just didn't work for me. Now this game, while on Early Access, there's a lot of really amazing stuff going on in the game. The game can become for all the platforms later on, but it was just amazing. I actually really got excited playing the game. I had a hard time to let go of the controller so I could make this video. And to be honest, if you guys ever enjoyed platform shooters, even if you left platform shooters a long time ago for whatever reason, I think you should try this game. You can find it on Steam for $14.99. The price can vary depending on which country you are. I actually checked out the price in Brazil, it's about half the price. Now you guys gotta understand, you probably think it's unfair when other countries get a different pricing by Steam. A lot of it has to do with how much money people actually make a month. Can they actually afford any game above $9 or even less? But again, great game, amazing game, the storyline is great, I love that the levels are randomized, so you never play the same game around. When you die, if you just kind of try to set out a path that you did before, you're gonna find a barrier and you won't be able to go through. You're gonna have to find your new way through. And that was amazing. That's something that a lot of people, a lot of studios should learn from a small studio. Really excited about seeing how this game gonna fare in 2020 when it fully comes out to all platforms. I think you guys should check it out if you have a chance. Be on videos or even going to the Steam store and getting that game. I will support a studio like this that actually can get me back in this type of games. It's something from my childhood, it's something that used to be really excited, and they're able to get me excited about that again. So I'll give this game an A-. Check this game out. Definitely do. It's worth it. Again, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I would love any criticism, any opinions about the game. If you guys had a chance to play or if you plan to play this game, don't forget to subscribe, give me a like in the end of this video, and I hope you guys have a great day. Thanks for watching.